Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We are here straight live with Triple Play Esports versus the Untouchables. The knife has already been done, and we're in round one for the pistol round. And we'll have the Untouchables versus Triple Play Esports, dear me. And Tesla kind of faking out on towards that B site. And we'll have Klaus J and Steve Ozer defending the A bomb site against four players when they do come in. Steve Ozer kind of hopping over. And we'll see what's going to happen. Oh, actually, Stavoza spots all those players, but being tagged up for his trouble. Kostya around the corner does manage to take out one. Stavoza follows, but it's a two-for-two trade. And the T's will now have control over that A site. And still waiting on Triple Esports to make their way towards that A site. They are going to get locked out. Taslak actually being tagged up through the wall by Xilianer. As we'll have them approach. Eddie V will take out one. Taslak goes down. It is down to Ferret. Ferret picks up one. Find some more. Actually follow up Ferret with the second one into Nico. That will be the first round for the Untouchables. 1-0 on the pistol round.
Right. Well, way to start the game. And not that much downtime to start with. Not our faces to look at. Just instant action. And that's the way I like it. So 1-0 for the Untouchables on the T side of Cobblestone. And oh dear me, am I happy that we're seeing something that isn't Mirage. I wanted to say I'm happy that we're seeing Cobblestone, but not per se. Anyway, good round by the Untouchables. They used that fake nicely, but it could have gotten a little bit closer if Kaje did a little more work from that position, if he would have let them go by at first maybe, but either way, it didn't happen, and let's see if they can get something out of this round worth it.
Yeah, well, so far they're taking it very carefully and not wanting to overcommit just yet, as we do have Revenant kind of lurking around on towards A. A couple of shots being fired off, but nothing really happening. It's a bit of a all quiet on the Western Front style. As Revenant does come in and actually finds the back of Kostya, and in comes the Shank. Kostya goes down. Revenant is just going to crawl around, find Steve Ozer as well, and that's going to be a huge bank account for Revenant. As Nico will be shut down as well by Taslak, and look at that. Triple Play Esports getting absolutely butchered, literally. So we honor. Oh, does pick up the kill on the Revenant, so just make something work. They pick up two kills, but now that bomb is being planted on towards that B bomb side, and looks like they are going to save those SMGs for the next round.
Well, it's more than they started with, and it might actually be something worth it. After all, they got those two frags and the two SMGs that came out of it, and well, next round they normally wouldn't be able to buy anything, so having two SMGs and two players still with Kevlar, that's going to help, and they both have an upgraded pistol as well, which they can drop to one of their teammates. So I think saving this is definitely worth it, and it could actually give them some nice chances in the next round, at least to get a few frags. But nice disciplined play here by the Untouchables as they just push out together. No one's going hunting. They don't care about these SMGs. They all have rifles, and they would like to hang on to those. So luckily, they do exactly that, and hopefully Revenant and Taslak don't go for a full rifle. Actually, they both get another SMG, so that's perfect. They were the ones that died, so they were the ones that economy got impacted, and another SMG to try and get some more SMG frags here is definitely a good idea. But let's see how those SMGs on the triple play side are going to be coming into play.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to wait and see. I mean, Soyana is definitely using the SMG in the right position towards that drop room. Taslak is going to be there, but he's going to horrendously out-time Tilianer as he will go down. Nico, they pick up a frag, but that's going to be it. Ferret will take him out. Revenant quickly following up with a frag to end the V. And suddenly, that B-bomb site is completely open. And you have Kostya and Steve Ozer doing all they can, rotating as fast as they can towards that B-bomb site. But just the 5-7 for Steve Ozer and the full pistol for Kostya. Yeah, I don't see this going anywhere in a favor of them for the Untouchables. Taslak already putting Kostya nearly out of his misery. But yeah, looks like they might just gonna go for that exit frags, which was probably the idea after all.
Right, well, another strong round by the Untouchables, and not really managed to utilize all of those SMGs they had to full effect, but they got some frags, and just another one being picked up by Stivoser there helps out. No real reason for Kasia to be saving this, to be honest, because he's likely going to be buying something better next round anyway. But, you know, he's on 3 HP, so running in isn't going to help him much either. And maybe one of his teammates is poor enough to want to play with it, but I very much doubt it.
Well, Stivoser with an 8 LVP.
He's actually keeping it.
I don't know.
Kasia is keeping the MAC-10. I do not agree.
That's clear talk. That's what I like.
I know. Okay, well, we've got three players with rifles, luckily, on this B site, and that should be plenty, even though there's the Untouchables that are coming dangerously close that really want to take that long control, but so far haven't decided to push in there yet. And this position that we see Nico going into now, I'm not sure if the stream is on that as well, but the tree position on the B site is really turning into like a default stronghold position, like a linchpin position. It's really, really strong, and you see frag clips of it being very effective time and time again. So let's see if Nico is going to be able to live up to the name that he has chosen for himself, that, you know, someone else also has, who's a little bit more notable. But yeah, let's see if he can make the position work for him. And there's some very hesitant play coming out of the Untouchables here. They are still just waiting out for that smoke. Not really much map control on the rest of the map. CTs, though, are just sitting there passively over towards long together. Kasia still with his MAC-10. Luckily has Stivoser close to him, but don't think that they're going to be needing each other's backup as the B play is coming into effect.
Well, Nico initially not hitting a single shot there, but does finally take out Scandalous. Stivoser coming in quickly enough to say shut down that bomb planter, and Stivoser we had another frag taking out Tasklike. Gonna pull out the pistol and will shut down A-Kid. So 3-1. That could have went entirely different, but luckily Stivoser with a fast rotation to take out three players on towards that bomb side, and that's gonna secure the round for Triple Play Esports.
Right. Well, Triple Play make it work. They get their first round on the board, and the Untouchables still have plenty of money to buy. But they do have two SMGs on the 3P side, which could work out. But, you know, I'm not very enthusiastic about considering the proper buy-up that the Untouchables are carrying around. Either way, you never know. It is still CS, and it looks like a very similar slow approach to the map control. Just taking angles, waiting if the CTs are going to push, slowly moving up further and further, and in the end, trying to collapse onto the right bomb site and get some frags, but last round didn't work out for them. Gonna try the exact same approach. Maybe it will this time, but this crossfire on the B side is looking quite strong. Two of those players, close quarters, able to help each other out, and a third very close by.
Well, that nade is gonna do a lot of damage. That brought Ferret down to 69 and Revenant to 57, so that's definitely worth the money. Oh well. Things are going to have to happen soon. We're running down the timer. And that's often seen in Cobblestone. It just kind of burst out the last couple of seconds. ADV having the Uzi from, I believe, the second round back. As Kostya picked that up. Then we'll have Natiz soon approach the site. Taslak will go in first. It's kind of unorthodox. Just go in like that with an 8 LP, but he has got himself enough support. Xiliana with the first one onto A-Kit. Goes very well. ADV coming in the back, taking out two players. He's gonna pick up the 8 LP. Dust with that player, but Xiliana will be there to take him out. 3-2, very solid defense from Triple Play Esports. And luckily, I mean, ADV used that SMG really well, but maybe a bit of trouble from the Untouchables not to cover the ramp like that.
Right. Well, we do see a little bit of a technical pause coming in called by the Untouchables, a sound problem on one of the players. So out of the game for a little bit.
That round.
Sorry?
That might have just explained that round because ADV was just allowed to walk up there.
Yeah, well, apparently that was a sound issue, or, you know, that's what we can assume. It's the closest we can get to an explanation. So let's go with it. But so far, so good, to be honest. The Untouchables managed to pick up the first three well done by them, not giving away any free rounds, but, you know, then following two rifle rounds go in the way of triple play. And is there money on the Untouchables? There is some, but I don't think they'll be buying up. Only Ferret has a good amount of money, and he's probably just dropping some pistols to everyone. So we are back into the game, and we're going live with round number 6, 2-3 for the Untouchables, and two ops, actually, on the CT side, and an MP9, which is going to be working wonders against the 5 unarmored pistols that are going to be running at it. Actually, they're not, because the SMG is on the B side, and everyone's going A, so...
Oh man, look at that position from Kostya, just standing on top of that wall. Steve Ozer with 2, Kostya with 2, and that's the way it's supposed to go.
That's a very strong position, because it's like flat out of your field of view. If you're down there that low, and you're just looking up front, you know, even if you're looking a little bit up, you don't see it. It's too high. So it's a perfect position. You look like you're very vulnerable, but in reality, nobody ever checks. So that worked out nicely. I don't hope they'll be using it too much, but in the end, because in the end, they will start checking. But for now, it got them another nice round on the board, and that makes it 3-3.
Again, the similar situation with the Untouchables, just slowly creeping their way up towards B. And I think their kind of game plan is to wait for Triple Esports to make a mistake by over picking a touch. We do have Eddie B there with the 8LP picking up a first kill, but as soon as he did this, and that's what I like to see from the Untouchables, as soon as the Eddie B did peek, immediately all those players came rushing out, and they got 2 kills for it. Make that 3 as Tasla comes in from the backside. Kostya, though, he's managed to flank himself all the way around, but gets horrendously out-timed. And it's Steve Ozer and Kostya with it all to do. That bombing planted on B, which is not a good thing. And Steve Ozer, I don't know. That really just isn't particularly great. But 2-on-3, what can they... 2-on-2, actually. What happened?
People died. Now, let's see if Kostya is going to be having any luck with that shot as Tazlak takes him down. And 2-on-1 now for the Untouchables, as they really want to win another round. They've lost a few in a row now. They're done with that, and they managed to make it work. So, op saved on their side. Round 1, and full house for Revenant and Tasslak. Now, in terms of money, not looking all that great for the CTs, but some of them happen to have a little bit of extra cash lying around, able to drop teammates. Steve Ozer has his op in his hands, and in terms of utility, they're fine, but next round, I'm afraid, they won't be. So it's important for 3P, if they want to keep it competitive, to definitely do a lot of damage into this round, if not just win it flat out. And look at this, 4 members solid on the B side, at least at the start of the round. We got Zillianer rotating back now. But Steve Ozer picking up that first frag, actually, off the Tazlak.
Yeah. I mean, I just noticed a little thing that I really like to say, because nothing really is happening at the moment. Kostya's knife name is Call of Duty Kid. I don't know. Just made me
Kid?
Call of Duty Kid. Yeah, just made me jiggle inside.
Okay. Yeah. Well, aren't you the biggest Call of Duty Kid of them all?
Yeah, of course. Well, Kostya doing some nice job taking out Revenant. Xiliana is there as well, taking out A Kid and Scandalous. Coming in, but Kostya, is he going to be there? Yes, he is. Will answer the call as Ferret now. 1v5. What is he going to be able to do? 3 players on that A-bomb site. He's got himself the bomb with him as well, but he's not connecting a single shot onto Kostya as Kostya will take him out. That is 3 frags for the man, and is now 4-4.
And that is not a good thing for the economy of the Untouchables, as now they are broke. So maybe, yeah, they are picking up some pistols, actually getting some Kevlar behind it as well. Maybe not planning on buying next round, because 2 of them are on 0 right now. So accepting the double eco, or just going to go for another force in the next. But 4-4, it's actually keeping it relatively close. And, you know, generally you'd say Cobblestone is a CT-sided map, but it could go either way. And Steve Ozer picks up the first 2 frags with that op, whipped out the PT-50, dies to the Tech-9 of Ferret. But Nico chimes in with 2, actually, as Zillianer also picked one up. And that was a pretty nice cleanup there for triple play, only losing 2 members.
Yeah, well, 5-4, and the economy really starts to build up for triple play esports. You can see Kostya on 10k, Eddie V having a little bit of a low bank account, but that can be compensated with the banks of Kostya and Xiliana. As well, we have another round, but just the P250s to hand for the Untouchables. I can only see a 64 scoreline for Triple Esports, unless something horrendously will go wrong. So far, it's not looking to be like that. Xillion are actually being boosted up, and we'll take out one. We'll immediately fall back. Two kills now for Xillion. Eddie did drop Revenant, and it's only two players remaining, and, well, they are likely to walk to their grave. Nico actually got one locked out there, and AK just sitting around that corner. I don't think Triple plays with no ease there. So as long as they don't push.
Yeah, but there walks into two shooting rifles. That did not work out very well for him. His teammate, they definitely know he's there, but actually because of the smoke, manages to get out Farid with his Glock, 25 HP to his name, and that's basically it. There's P250 on the floor. Maybe he can do something with that. Not even going to pick it up and gets taken down. So 6-4, like you said, it was inevitable. And, you know, at least the Untouchables got a frag.
Yeah, I mean, I guess it's a big thing when you just have Glocks or the minimal investment.
Well, it's still not a very notable accomplishment, unfortunately. But this round, luckily, they are back to rifles. Everyone on the AK, plenty of utility to play around. And Steve Ozer going for an aggressive middle peek, going to get that information, know that there's no one there. And actually, it's looking like a very, very fast B play.
Yeah, finally, some fast plays coming in. But Nico, with the first frag already. Oh my god, nearly cut off the head of his teammate. Xillioner though did pick up one, but Scandal is gonna trade him in. 3-on-4. And already Steve Ozer coming in the back. Such an aggressive rotation from him. And not too sure if he's gonna be expecting it. Oh man. Steve Ozer will go down to Scandalous. And it's a 3-on-2 after plant. Eddie V. Kinda, oh man, Jesus. Take your time. 1-on-1. Scandalous. On the hat trick. Can he make it to George Foreman? Not gonna happen though. The pink AK. Nah. Eddie V will clutch it. 7-4.
Right, so it's starting to look very well actually for triple play in the half. And if the Untouchables, you know, because again, this is a CD sided map generally, but you want to get at least those 5-6 rounds because it's proven not to be that CT-sided if you know how to approach the T-side. So let's hope that in this final, you know, stay of execution that the Untouchables have right now with these AKs and barely any utility, they'll be able to make something work. But it's just another quick play towards that P-side. Didn't work out last round. Not sure if it will now as we have Nico in that linchpin position again on that tree. Doesn't actually pick anyone up, but spots four of them at least, and that grenade's going to be a touchdown.
Yeah, well, things have been lined up so far. Nico and Xillion are doing absolutely great work. Eddie V chiming in as well. Eddie V with two. Xillion with the last one. And the only man to go down was Eddie V himself, actually. 8-4 and Triple Play Esports truly pulling ahead in this one. They've been taking about 5 rounds in a row. And after a bit of a shaky start in the beginning, as the Untouchables did pick up 3 rounds. But, you know, very well played so far. Steve Ozer again. Might go for an aggressive peek towards long. He's got himself Kostya with him, so likely to do that. However, there's not going to be anyone to receive any sort of shots from him. As well, Tech Nines.
Yeah, again, Tech Nines, but also towards B. They seem to really, really like this site, and 3P seem to really like that. They like it so much because it's not working out very well for them, as Xillioner actually picks that first frag up comfortably and does get taken down by Revenant in return.
Mm-hmm. And now, the Tech Nines, will they come into play? Nico and Eddie V are gonna absolutely deny this one. As Steve Ozer does go down, Eddie V with the second one on the round, as Nico now having a skirmish and Parrot will take him out, luckily there. 9-4, Triple Play Esports. Playing very solid in that round, only losing two members, and I think that's quite a good trade-off against the Tech Nine rush.
Right. Well, finally, they can get rid of those Tech Nines and get some proper guns on the board as we finally see an op on both sides. Because we've seen Steve Ozer go for that peek on long at least 2 or 3 times, but never got peeked into. And now we got Steve Ozer on that B side, which does definitely seem like the side of choice for the Untouchables, as they are there again, and this time with an AWP on Tazla, no, on Revenant, but Tazla gets taken out first. Revenant directly after. Steve Ozer doesn't care, picks up two for his troubles, and I think he'll be going to be again.
Yeah, I mean, this is really Steve Ozer. He's such an aggressive AWPer, and this time it does pay off. Ferret actually creeping his way in, but Steve Ozer spots him as well. That's the hat trick for him. And he's gonna go for that repeat, but Nico will take him out. And I love the fact in the beginning of the round that Xiliana again being boosted off up onto the drop room. That just worked out great. And then Steve Ozer following up with three. That pretty much concluded the round. Triple Play Esports now leading by 6. It is 10-4. And it's just gonna be those AKs. I can only assume the Untouchables are gonna try something different now, because they've been going B about 3 or 4 rounds in a row, and it's not been paying off. And look at this, the aggressive play from Kostya already taking out 2 kills. And Scandalous will go down to Steve Ozer, so immediately this is being neutralized. Wow.
Triple Play having a very good half so far. And all by himself now, we have Akid with that bomb, luckily, and actually long completely. Oh, if he just walks into A now, he's fine. Unfortunately, he doesn't know that, so... Very passive hold here by Triple Play in the connector. Finally, we got Kostya peeking back in there, but nice position already by Akid as he picks up Kostya there. Goes for that bomb site and will be able to put down that bomb before Steve Ozer comes around the corner, but it's not going to be a very big margin as Steve Ozer is coming in closer together with his teammates, and Nico is going to be the one to take out Akid. Picks up the 11th round in the half here for Triple Play. Tremendously well done by them, and... Well, it's going to come down to the pistol round for the Untouchables if they want to bring it back here. I'm not sure how their CT side on this map is, but their T side wasn't all that elaborate.
Yeah. Well, Triple Play Esports, I mean, pretty surprised that I came back from it, from losing the 3 rounds. I mean, I know it's not a big deal losing the first 3 rounds, but still, I mean, they just took it round after round. And, well... Let's see how this pistol round is going to work out, like you said. I'm curious to see how they are going to approach this one. Are they going to go for that similar fake that the Untouchables did? We'll find out.
I think we have seen Triple Play before on Cobblestone. I'm not sure why I think that, but I do think they'll... it was MCON that we saw versus Lowland Lions maybe on Cobblestone? I'm not sure.
I think you're actually right, though. Triple Play Esports for sure played Cobblestone once.
They did? Okay, well, either way...
Yeah, against Venko Gaming, 16-7.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Okay, fair enough. But that was Venko. This time, it's the Untouchables, who are not exactly Venko. And Triple Play in the lead, 11-4, second pistol round of the game. And this game could be over very, very quickly if this pistol round goes the way of Triple Play because of their massive advantage. And let's see if the Untouchables have anything to say about that or if they're just going to be rolling over.
Well, Tazlak so far picking up the one pop, but he's going to get overwhelmed by EDV. And luckily, I mean, Tazlak, he did pick up some early information, and that allows the Untouchables to go for that rotation quickly. Kostya goes down, and I think the idea right now is for Triple Play Esports to kind of stick around and wait for the defense to split off again, and then make their way towards the A side yet again, and we'll see how this one is going to work out, because...
They are holding very deeply in that A site. We got Akid all the way over towards the truck and Revenant here in the corner. I'm not sure how this is called, but, you know, first thing that pops in my mind is Freiburg. So, you know, I'm going to call this Freiburg. But, you know, them being so deep into this site with their long-range pistols does put the terrorists at a slight disadvantage here. But they do have one more member, so... Maybe if they return properly, they'll be able to make it work. And actually, no need for returns. Xiliana just picks up 2.
Wow. They just got absolutely annihilated by that man. And Xiliana just made you eat your words, because he was on long range, taking out 2 players just like that. And Nico finishes it off with a 2-man as well. 12-4. This must be a nightmare situation for the Untouchables. And let's see if they're going to make do with the pistols, because... Those SMGs are going to come into play.
Oh, they're actually forcing. I was going to say, I hope they don't force. I hope they just accept these 2 rounds and try and make something out of it afterwards. Just get the strongest possible buy you can and try and sweep it up. And actually, this could work out better considering the over cockiness on the SMG buy with triple play. Like five SMGs, I'm going to stick with my opinion, is too much. You need at least one or two rifles to back that up, even if it's Galils, whatever. But let's see if it's going to work out. We got some upgraded pistols with Kevlar up against these SMGs on the 3P triple play side, and the bomb looks like it wants to go towards B, where three players are. Tazlak picks up a frag onto Stivozer with his CZ, and suddenly we're in a 4v4.
Yeah, no, Revenant. Oh my god! Just starts and takes out Xiliana Kostyado there to reply. And, well, Scandalous coming in with the shock and Kostya with another one. In the meanwhile, causing havoc as he takes out another frag. Scandalous down and out. It is Tazlak, your last man standing. He's not going to be standing for much longer as NFV shuts him down. 13-4. And, well, that is surely going to be 14-4 as just going to be the full pistol setup for the Untouchables. You can see only Tazlak having enough money to buy a P250. Revenant's actually going to do the same thing as well, but they're going to have to stick to that 2K. And this, again, is just going to be another round for Triple Play Esports to increase that bank account still with three SMGs left up alive.
Yeah, well, those SMGs actually working out nicely for them. And again, Nico just charging in, picks up three now with his UMP. Like you say, definitely hotwiring some cash to his bank account. And all of a sudden, Tazlak, last member left alive here as Nico's picked up three and Kostya has one under his belt. That was with a rifle though, so not all that notable, unfortunately. But Stivozer does have a UMP as well, wants to get that frag and does manage. So good amount of money earned for the triple play side. And normally it would be fine to keep these SMGs now just to do economical damage and see what you can make of it. But considering it's 14-4, you know that the Untouchables are going to be bringing everything they have, and you just want to bring whatever the fuck you can afford so you can make it happen as well. So I think this is going to be an exciting round. I hope the Untouchables come up with something creative to see if they have an opportunity at or have the chance at a stave execution. But to be honest, I don't think it's very likely.
Yeah, and it's definitely going to happen. I mean, the Untouchables, they're actually on 1 point in the group stage. So, I mean,
yeah,
they need something. They need a win. But same goes for Triple Play Esports. They've only got one win.
On 1 point as well?
Yeah, yeah, okay, but if they points. Do win this one, then, you know, they might just compete with Dutch Prodigy because yeah, they're exactly. On 7. So that's something to make it interesting. And Xiliana will throw out a couple of flashbangs and Revenant will go down quickly after. And then, I mean, Triple Play Esports, they're playing Cobblestone so well in at this current moment in time. They're playing, you know, confident. The Untouchables are just purely getting out-aimed and just outgained by the play of Triple Play Esports. And, well, maybe Scandalous is going to do something. But no, again, Nico, just with superior aim, takes him out. And that is going to be the call for the B push coming in. Yeah, Steve Ozer still on the backside. And that is going to be a clean round from Triple Play Esports. Only Eddie V to go down. It is a match point, 15-4.
And no money on the CT side. So, yeah, interesting to see Cobblestone. Unfortunate that, you know, most matches go 16-14 and this one goes 16-4, likely. Not yet. We're not quite there yet. We have a Max 7 and a UMP with three FAMASes still standing in the way of that. So let's see if that's going to be a big enough obstacle to stop 3P from snowballing this. But it looks like they might just run away with it as Kostya picks up the first, but actually two return frags coming in from the Untouchables. And Nico picks up one to make it a 3v3 after plans.
Well, 2-on-3 now. Make that a 1-on-3. Nico, what can you do? Picks up the first frag. Can he go for the win here? As he's going to have to reload his AK. Those players now approaching the site, but AK will save that A. 15-5.
Okay, so they managed to take down Nico, win the round, A-Kid with a 3K, well done by him, and that keeps them in the game a little bit longer, but how much money are they on? They might still not be able to buy properly throughout their team in term. Yeah, those two guns saved might help, but in general, their money isn't looking all that spectacularly, and Triple Play, on the other hand, from all those SMG frags, has plenty of money to work with, have everything their heart desires. And this is sort of the end of the line for the Untouchables already. Then again, it doesn't really matter how many rounds you lose at the moment because one loss means that the game is over. So for them, it's just about the wins and not about the economy anymore.
Yeah, well, a 10-round deficit is quite huge, and I don't know. I just don't think this is gonna last for much longer. But could be mistaken.
To be honest, I have to agree. But you know, they are, if they're gonna make this work, if they're gonna at least attempt at getting something more done throughout this game, then this is their opportunity. First of all, because it's literally over if they lose, but also they have everything they need. They have an op, they have four rifles. No one's at a massive deficit besides a utility maybe, but doesn't seem to hinder them quite as much. So map control is gained here by Zillioner as he's in the drop-down area, and not much response from that on the Untouchable side. Actually, there we go, finally picking up that frag, taking away that map control, and that's reason enough for the bomb to be rotating over towards the A site, where we only have one player.
Hmm. This could get interesting. Taslak nearly getting caught off guard, and Kostya does take out Revenant. Now Taslak with an 8 OP on very close range. He's not going to connect that chop, and that is going to be done. As Eddie V cleans him out, Nico will down Aked as well. Nico with the second frag of the round. It's going to be down to Skendulus, 1-on-3. Can he keep the Untouchables in the game? As the bomb now being planted, Nico will go looking. Skendulus takes him out, though. Those are going down as well. Kostya versus Skendulus. As Kostya is watching that position, but Skendulus takes him out, and this should not be happening. Not like that, but Skendulus does it 1-on-3, 15-6, courtesy of that man.
Don't want to take anything out of the 1v3 that Skendulus just pulled off, but that was just flat out triple play, giving it away. Giving 3 1v1s to, you know, in a 3v1 situation instead of just holding back and pulling a, like, peeking out altogether as soon as he's on or close to the bomb. So that was on them, maybe a little bit too frag horny, maybe just want to close out the game, but didn't work out. And as punishment, they have to sit through at least one other round in which they are suddenly at a little bit of a disadvantage, but they seem to be prepared. They got some smokes going on, and they already have pushed out onto the site. Going to be trying to get that return frag as Akid gets the first, but no luck so far as Ferret also picks up the frag.
Well, it's gonna go either way, because now it's 2v2. Make that a 1v2. It's now, again, a clutch situation, but this time in the hands of Taslak. 1v2, as we do have those two players sneakily making their way towards the A bomb site, slowly but surely. And Taslak with an ALP. I don't know, maybe you should just pick up an AK, go for that extra firepower, as both players are actually tagged up quite heavily.
But he has realized by now that they are going towards the B site. I'm not sure why they're still sneaking, because by the time they get there, or the A site, I mean, by the time they get there, he's already going to be in position. And that could work out a little bit more nasty than it needs to. But they are still with two people, so if they return on each other properly, they have plenty of opportunity to make it work. But it's also another opportunity for the Untouchables to, you know, come a little bit closer to maybe tying.
Oh man, Taslak with the CZ takes out Eddie V. Connect that one. That would have been nice in style, but Xiliana will take him out. 16-6 would be the score, and that is a very well deserved win for Triple Play Esports.